Okay. Now, there are three technology product groups for Java. I'd like to call them flavors of Java. Since we like to drink coffee, let's talk about the three flavors of Java. Now, for our full-blown course, we will discuss Java SE, or Java Standard Edition. It is used to create desktop applications like the Notepad application that you've seen earlier, or even simple desktop games, okay? You can even create applets for Java SE. Now, for mobile devices, we have Java ME for that. Okay, Java ME stands for Java Micro Edition. Now, don't confuse Java ME with Android. Java ME is the old version that is used for Nokia phones. So probably you haven't heard Nokia for a while, but I'm sure your mom and dads know what a Nokia phone looks like, okay? So during the good old days when they still have Nokia and they still have the Asha series, when we still have the personal digital assistant or PDAs, okay? We use Java ME to create applications for smaller devices, such as PDA or cell phones. But nowadays, we don't use Java ME anymore for mobile devices. Instead, we use Java SE for Android application. Now, Android is a separate product. When you hear the term Java, the technology owner today is Oracle. And before Oracle, it was created by a company called Sun Microsystems. Android, on the other hand, is a product created by Google. The people who created Gmail, the guys who created Google, they're also the guys who created Android. So Android makes use of Java as their backend. All right? You know why? The two students. These are PhD students, okay? Just a little bit of side story. Larry Page and Sergey Brin, I think, the people who created Google, they were students, a PhD student in Stanford University. They're taking up a PhD course, and they created Google, the initial... The initial brand for Google is actually Google. Now, Google is a mathematical term, and then they decided to change it to Google. Now, they are from Stanford. I think they created Google in 1996 or 1997, if I'm not mistaken. Now, they initially used Java for Google, all right? And now they created Android, and they still use Java at the back end. But for the modern version of Android, you already have an option either to use Java or Kotlin for the back end. Okay? Now, why did they use Java as the back end for Android? Maybe because they came from Stanford University. Now, what's so special about Stanford? Remember earlier when I said that Java was created, Java is owned by Oracle? And previously, it was owned by Sun Microsystems. Now, Sun, S-U-N, is actually an acronym for Stanford University Network. All right? And if you're thinking what I'm thinking, then you're probably right. Java was actually created and by students and faculty members and researchers from Stanford University. All right, so Stanford University already produced two technology giants. Java came from Sun Microsystems. Sun basically means Stanford University Network. And Google came from PhD students who were students from Stanford University as well. So maybe you would like to go to college in Stanford, right? Now, so we already have Java SE, okay? So in our course offering here at TechDev Academy, we do offer courses for Java SE and Java ME. Now, another technology that we can use for web page development or web applications development is called Java EE. All right? Now, building a web page is different from building a website. You need a page inside your website so that, you know, people, when they visited www.somethingsomething.com, they will see a landing page, or also known as your web page. All right? But at the back of those pages are a bunch of Java codes that is running, and we call them JSPs and servlets, or also known as web components. They can now make use of the information that you've entered in the page, like the number of likes, the number of thumbs up, and they can pull all of those information, your name, your age, your birthday, they can pull all of those information from the web page, and they can process it, and then they can save it in the back end, in the databases. That is normally what is done by your e-commerce and e-business web websites. So if you're trying to do an online banking, chances are you're seeing a web page, but something else is happening at the back end. So Java can be a powerful tool to create those enterprise-based solution. So for example, you have an enrollment system running on your respective schools. I think right now, most schools are doing enrollment online. Even here, we're teaching online, right? So you can even enroll or buy something online. Chances are you have some Java codes running at the back end. Okay? So these are the three technology groups that we can use, that we can study, huh? If you're interested in learning Java. Now, what's the relevance between the three? So if you wanted to learn Java, you need to start with Java SE. Okay? Now, if you'd like to earn money from what you're learning, I suggest you start learning Java Enterprise Edition after you've learned Java SE. So you always need to start somewhere, and you start with Java SE, because Java SE is the underlying technology of Java EE. Java EE is where you can now combine your knowledge in HTML, CSS, JavaScript, together with Java SE. All right? Now, Java EME, or the micro edition, well, this is also something that is nice to know, but it's not that famous nowadays, unlike Swift or Android. Okay? So, these are the different technologies. I don't want to overwhelm you with what you're seeing right now. These are a lot of technologies, but as I would like to give emphasis here is, when we talk about Java EE, this is not just a one-man show, okay? This can be separated by three different technology groups. Technology group for integration, for development, and for container management. In other words, it will be very hard for just one person to manage the entire Java EE web application, or what we call full stack application. So there are different types of training, different types of people who can manage a full-blown Java EE application. But again, what I also like to focus on is, we always need to start with Java SE. In some cases, you might hear the term core Java instead of Java SE. The reason why it's called core Java, because it's in the core. You need to study Java SE first. All right? Now, let me just jump back some few slides right about here. Okay, when we talked about the Java virtual machine. Okay, so earlier in the chat, I saw a chat who someone asking, what should we install, or what about the JDK? All right, let me just check it out. I think it's a question from Anush, JDK question mark? So Anush is asking what JDK to use. Now, what is the JDK? For some of you who doesn't have any idea about Java, let me tell you what the JDK is all about. JDK stands for, okay, give me 1 minute. Okay, JDK stands for Java Development Kit. Okay, this is the installer that you need to use if you want to install an application that can be used to compile your code, that can be used to create codes. All right, so if you want to create codes, you need to compile it and you need to run it. So if you're a developer or if you're a student, you'll be needing the Java Development Kit installed on your machine. Now, if you're not a developer, if you're just an end user, all you need to do is to install the JRE. Now, the JRE stands for Java Runtime Environment, and it only has two components inside, the JVM and the API. Now, you don't have to worry about our session today, because for our session, we don't need to install anything. We just need to have a browser, okay? But if you enroll the full-blown course, I'm going to teach you how to properly install and configure the Java Development Kit on your machine. For now, we'll just use an online compiler, okay? Now, so you'll see that the JRE is just a subset of the JDK. So whenever you install the Java Development Kit, you're automatically installing the Java Runtime Environment as well. Okay? Now,
be sure to join TechDev Academy's workshops and camps and also read some great articles on their blog page.